live in outer space riding on a giant asteroid at Sunny Alpha Stadium, home of the Galaxy Chaos.
Oh, that would explain the text I just got from Event Horizon Wireless, informing me I got $5,000 in roaming charges. I wonder how much that text just cost me.
Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers. The Orcs of Hazzard battle the Galaxy Chaos. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hello again, everybody. Grim Blitzrow here, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
That's me.
And his mutant hobbit head that lives on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
How about you shut the fuck up?
Well played, Jr. Moving on. First and 10. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Except the zombies. They are free.
Tired of the quarterback's tight spirals and mech. And that unsportsmanlike play of the day brought to you by the good folks at Speedy's Drive Through Funeral Parlor Service, located just off the Beltway Exit 5. And it's first and 10. A big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About 3:15, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
Second down and a lot. Defense gives up 5 yards on that pass play. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. Not many kickers can kick it over 50 yards in these brutal conditions. Let's see if he can do what few others can.
That was like a movie trailer, Grim.
And I don't want to see the comment section on that replay of the kick. Yeesh, that was terrible.
Yeah, he's gonna get the Ray Funkel treatment after that miss.
And he gets his bell rung for a yard. Second down and 9. Four yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
3rd down and 6. That one in for a first down to keep the drive alive. And it's 1st and 10. Boom! Second down and more than the QB would like. And he just slipped away like a greased pal with the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. About a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
I'm gonna say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Looks like the defense called the ginormous dirty trick. That's a whole lot of player right and into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. And here comes the extra point attempt. Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. That's how you run it, folks. Picks up 8 there. Second down and 2. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just all over. First and 10. And he's running like a moose right now. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
Second down and long. If you don't think you can make the interception, batting it down is the next best thing.
Great advice, Grim. That receiver's gonna go far in this league if he listens to you.
I wasn't talking to... Yeah, never mind. Yes, Brick, he will. And the runner is moving crazy fast. Look at the path he's taking. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. And it's 1st and 10. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Second down in a very lot. trick. The quarterback unleashed. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's gonna be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
First and 10. The defense better look out. The offense called the beast boost dirty trick.
He hit that line the way a Republican congressman hits the airport men's room. Good and hard. First down.
And it's first and 10.
On several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Second down and 10. The way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. Third down and 5. This guy's gonna get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. For a kick this far, you just gotta kick it as hard as you can, partner.
And aim! It's really important from this distance.
It's probably a smart idea. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah. That's why he named his clothing company.
Hey, Bricks, you were hit more than a few times like that in your career.
140 times to be exact, and one game to be more exact, during one play to be more and more exact. It wasn't even a game, actually. Coach just laid into me on the sidelines.
And it's first and 10.
I personally think the ginormous guy...
And then he jars the ball loose, and it's a fumble! That's what happens when you hurdle and take a hard hit. Second down and 9. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage. Third down and 9. When it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, with the brain scrambler. first and 10. And he breaks away. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And he takes a timeout here. They have two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just going to take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
It's a 2-yard run before he stopped. They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. And he picks up about 6 on the play. The quarterback burns his last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore. 3rd down and 3. Caught for the first down. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score. Huge pass play for 1 yard. 2nd down and 9. With the brutal hit. 1st down and 1. That's a killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in fantasy.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done! Dirty trick called by the D, and the offense is pissed. Well, for you kids at home, that's how you play mutant football.
Hey, wait a minute. What the? Didn't they just... am I losing my mind? Or did that play that I saw just not happen? I gotta stop smoking them untidy laundry pods.
The 2nd quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsatan Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. And these guys are neck and neck to begin the 3rd quarter.
You're talking about them 2 Siamese twins playing opposing tackles? Yeah, they're putting on a hell of a show.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
Oh, he just got popped big time.
Oh, my God. I thought his head was going to pop off like a big zit.
And it's 1st and 10. Nice run there for 8 yards. Second down and 2. He took a beast boost injection. Now wants him to stomp all over his opponents.
I want to take a beast boost injection too.
Now that has weird side effects, Briggs. Man, he hit buffet of crabapple trees, Bricks.
You're telling me. She ate 47 Salisbury steaks one time. Thought she had food poisoning. Turns out her lower intestines just exploded.
No, that's a relief, because there's nothing worse than food poisoning.
You're telling me.
And it's first and 10.
He's got a good chiropractor.
Second down and 7. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Down and 8. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
I watch our kicker make a kick like this with his extra leg. He used it like a golf club.
That wasn't a leg, you moron. That was Tripod Jenkins, the one with the big slot.
Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Man, what a hit that was. First and 10. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
And it's first and 10. And that pass play is good for 8 yards. Second down and 2. Left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
At most.
Speaking of deuces, I got a hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
Look out, that's an all-out attack on the QB. His only chance is to run out of bounds. And the quarterback says, I don't think so, and runs out of bounds, leaving the defense in the dust. Nice try, fellas, but no cigar.
Speaking of cigars, I gotta go to the camp.
Third down and 9. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. is, I'm taking you with me. First and two. Not much there, maybe a yard. And that'll bring up second and one. Should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
We're tied up at the end of the third quarter. You can smell the excitement on the fans. I mean, literally, it is ripe in here. Man.
Dunya, was that you?
Hey, blow me.
It's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and seven. Down and nine. And he'll pick up 7 yards on that play. Punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he's got a chance for a good return here. So now they'll need to find another player on the bench to punt from here on out.
Yeah, who gives a crap about punters anyway?
Punters' moms, wives, kids? But that's about it.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. Brick Shithouse. It's first and 10. And the defense just called it. Oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurdle and get hit, chances for a fumble increase. Second down and 10. That's a gain of 10 yards. Third down and a pussy hair. First and 10. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a pick ahead. Get the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
Somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had shown on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And like a monkey trying to fuck up, and the quarterback finds his man for the first down. And it's first and 10. Scores handily. Oh, and the defense just called a time warp dirty trick. And now it's like everything that just happened didn't.
Get Brick's mom on the phone quick. I want to use 13,000 of those time warps and undo a mistake she did about 35 years ago.
The offense calls their first time out. Second down and 6. He picks up 5 on that play. They stop the clock, but they only have 1 timeout left.
That's okay, Grim. They can have mine.
That's nice, Bricks. But our timeouts are for our sponsors, and we need money more than they do. And he runs into the end zone for a touchdown. Shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. He sits up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. He just got crushed. And it's first and 10. If you don't hear it coming, it'll knock you right on your ass. And that is called for a first down. And it's first and 10. Quarterback threads the needle for a first down. first and 10. And a nice pass for a 10-yard gain.
It's not a first down in the stat line, but it's a first down in our hearts.
It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
That's right, folks. It's all tied up, and we are headed to overtime. I don't know how many players are left alive, but the rest are headed to sudden death.
They should call this game Mutant Death League.
Breaks overtime is a war with some basic rules. The first touchdown wins the game, but if the team that receives the kickoff gets a field goal, then the other team is allowed a possession too. After that, whomever scores wins.
Grandma, I didn't understand any of that. Can you repeat?
Man, what a hit. That guy is not getting up. Was there, but he still picked up a yard somehow. Second down and 9. And that's a sack.
Speaking of sacks, has anybody seen my powder? I'm itching like crazy over here.
Down and, well, good luck. And the NFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
Comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. You've got to avoid those spikes or you'll be a mutant pincushion.
I was a chubby kid, Grim. My parents sent me to fat camp. My big brother told me as soon as you get there, stab the first kid you see and no one will mess with you. So I get off the bus at the camp, some kid runs up to me and stabs me.
It's first and 10. Oh, great tackle! When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a car for wasn't home.
Second down and 5. Looks like they're just going to pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon offense.
I'm not going to touch that one.
That's what she said.
Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
And it's first and 10. Galaxy Chaos have lost the game.
And I'm out $50.
They battled hard, but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chimp dicks?
Yeah.
God, that was beautiful. Grim Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.